Just think of what we can do differently that Airbnb doesn't do. So as a hotelier, when they came to me and said, Kike, we want you to help us do a strike on Airbnb because it's stealing your money. I said, first of all, I don't think it's stealing my money. I like the company. What a brilliant idea. Why didn't I think about it? And I decided that I didn't use Airbnb for different reasons. If I travel, I want security. I want to know that the apartment really exists, because we've heard very good things about Airbnb, but we've also heard bad things. So I thought that I could fix the bad things, which are basically I can go, if you come to a BMate, which is the company I founded, is that you can find apartments that I guarantee that they exist. The pictures are mine, I do them. I don't let everybody come into the platform. I just let the apartments I choose with the good hosts and nice apartments. And I give them services from the hotel. They can leave their luggage, they can pick up the keys 24 hours. And basically, most important of all, I give them concierge service 24 hours a day, which I already have in my hotels. So what we're doing is different. Airbnb is catering. You find right now that in the industry, in the apartments, you have the top-notch One Fine Stay, Trump Soho apartment, Majestic, and then you have Airbnb or HomeAway who just give you the key. There was nothing in between. No, this one was very expensive and this one was not. And we decided to put BMate there, which is apartments with hotel services at affordable prices.
For me, the key is creating a little more differentiation.
Of course.
A few more strata in the market.
I mean, right now there's an obvious niche, which is the younger people like Airbnb and they really don't look for these kind of things of security services. There comes a certain age where you do. No, maybe you don't because you're almost my age, but you do normally. Normally, the average age in Airbnb, it's between 28 and 30 years old. After 31, it drops. And those are the ones I want to target. No, the people who need services, who want security, and who want something else. I want cleaning every day. They want a nanny. They want a transfer. So that normally they wouldn't go to an Airbnb. They don't want to be spending a fortune on the high-end levels, and they still want to use an apartment.
How does your new experience project feed into this?
It's very interesting. Experience came out because the people were asking us to help them. No, listen, I have a small hotel in the center of a city or outside of the city, and we want you, can you guys give us a hand? Can you guys tell us how we do our SOPs, which is standard procedures, how we treat the client, and especially how do we commercialize our hotels? And so we developed with Pricewaterhouse a very good algorithms of telling how we can predict what the customer wants, but not just only to make the client pay more, which is basically what many of the companies are trying to do. I'm not interested in that. I'm interested in having my client happier, because if they're happier, they'll be willing and happy to spend more money, no? So at the end, everything we're doing is always client-oriented, thinking how we can get the client happier, because that way he will come back, he will be a recurrent customer, and that's how we also developed a new word. I hate the word hospitality. I hate it. Hospitality reminds me of hospitals. So invented a new word called Happitality.
Happitality.
Which we registered, by the way.
It's a trademark.
It's a trademark, and it's making happy guests, happy clients. So it's called Happitality, and that's what I would like all the industry to be thinking always. How do I make happy clients?